Welcome back to Farming Simulator 2015 with Rude Man. We're back on Cherry Hills, and Cherry Hills had an update, so we're on 1.1 now, and I didn't really read to see what the changes were. I think they're just small changes. The map doesn't seem to be too much different, but I did have to restart the game because... I wasn't able to just take over where I left off. My save game wouldn't work. So on the new version, and so I had to start over. Well, that's fine. I just started the game, so all I did was the first harvest. I did, though, while I was away. Well, let's look at the map. I did seed the two fields I had. I have field two and field one. And I did reseed them. I seeded two with wheat, and I seeded one with potatoes, because I want to be able to feed the animals potatoes. Now, I did use the little bit of potatoes that come with the map. It's not very much. And I did feed some of the animals. Well, one of the animals I fed with potatoes. As you see, I worked for a little couple hours and got me back to where I was when I ended the last episode somewhat. I have my straw and my grass and my chaff. I have the silage in the silage fermenting silo. I've got the mixing stations full. Everything's being worked, so I'm back where I was. I did do a couple things, though, offline that I hadn't done in the last episode, and I'll show you what those are. I think I left a truck over there. I did. Okay. So if we look at the map, I'm over... Where am I? Okay. Yeah, I'm northeast of the farm. I'm east of the second farm. The second farm is right here. There's our main farm. There's our second farm. This is the compost maker. That's where I'm at. What I decided to do was to take some of the silage that I have made and bring it over here and fill these things up. I've got two of these things running with compost because I need compost to run certain things. So now I probably don't have very much compost, because I just did that yesterday when I got this map back up to where I was. And so there hasn't been any farm time that has went on to have these things do any work. Let me check. I don't think I have very much. Well, I have some. Not a lot, but there's some there. Yeah, see, it's not very much. I have to have a little bit of farm time go by because I just filled these things. They're actually full. These diesel tanks take a full diesel load of the big tanker. Each one of them took a full diesel tanker load. These, when you put stuff in them, don't take all that much. About two loads, and they were both full of whatever you want to put in there. If you want to put straw... I think I put one load of straw in, and I put at least one or maybe two loads of chaff. So it takes about two to three truckloads, and then it's full. And then you have to wait till it makes the compost. I did put in a silo dump here and a silo input and output. The mod is called a transfer station. I did put one of those in so that I can quickly do this and put my compost in here, and then I can share it throughout the map at wherever I have a place that I can get these. So let me go ahead and dump this compost in there, and then if I go in here, it should show that I have compost. Let's see. Yeah, see, shows I have compost. So now I've got a little bit of compost, and I can maybe start operating the gardens. Let's see. Now, the gardens, they are at the garden shop, I think, which is... Yeah, the garden shop is right by the VGA, so everything is pretty centrally located on this map. I like that. I really do. There was some map. Gosh, Los Hills. When I played Los Hills, it was like... And the funny part was, in the description it said, yes, this is a very big map, but it's okay because we've got everything easily... You can get to everything easily. Well, that was a bunch of BS. The map was so big and everything was spread completely out across the map. And you ended up having to drive back and forth for miles to get to anything. It was kind of funny. It was a huge map. This one is as well, but... Okay, so yeah, this is... Here's the garden center. Let's see here. Whoop. I got myself stuck. Yeah, see, here's your... what do we got here? Compost. There's your lettuce, it looks like. Maybe some cabbage. Pumpkins. Red cabbage. Tomatoes. You got all your stuff here. I may have not got that right, but there you go. Now, how do we get access to our compost? Let's see. All right, we got fertilizer and seeds here. That's a good thing, I suppose. Okay, there is no way to get our compost, so what sells here? Eggs? I like that Stevie uses those yellow and black markers to show you where the triggers are. That's cool. A lot of times you have to kind of hunt and peck for the triggers. As a matter of fact, I usually have to go in here into the console to find the triggers in some places. But see, even here where it's obvious that there's manure here, you've got it marked. Oh, there's our compost right there. Okay, well, how do we get it? How do we get it? Well, I guess maybe you need a dump truck or something, or a front loader or something to get that. All right, well, I don't want to do that, so I'll tell you what I can do. I put in a transfer station over right here at the BGA. That's pretty handy. So I can run in here. Yeah. Yay me. I can run in here and get my compost. I don't know if it's enough to do what I want to do, but it's convenient. All right, let's get that little bit of compost that I could have brought it with me because I drove the truck from the compost factory, but I didn't. I could have, but I didn't. But I could have. Okay, let's see if we can find the old compost. There's the chaff, there's the straw. There are different kinds of straw, I guess. I don't know. There's hay, there's seeds, there's the silage, there's mixed rations. We don't have any evidently yet. Wood chips, fertilizer, manure, slurry, homogenized milk. I can get homogenized milk out of that? Potatoes, which we don't have any yet. Steamed potatoes, which we don't have because we don't have potatoes. Pig forage, yeah, we haven't made that yet either. Beet pulp, we haven't done beets yet. Compost, and there we are. Let's grab that compost. And I need my water truck over here too. You know what I could do? I could go get my water truck. Oh, I'll show you something else I did while I was offline. I know you're saying, why'd you do everything offline? I don't know. I really seriously been thinking about doing some live streaming again. I did very little live streaming. I don't like it. I shouldn't say I don't like it. It's not that. Let's see, I need to set a transfer course. I'm a sensitive guy. And if I do live streaming, I'm just scared to death that somebody's going to you know, be mean to me in the chat. So, I don't know. I've been thinking about it, though. Hang on. Let me see. What was I doing? I want to go to the bio. This one right here. It's not... It's Grass 17. It's not the bio thing, but... Yeah, I don't... Oh, what are you doing? Get out of the way. I don't want to be harassed while I'm just trying to have fun. So I'm always worried that's what's going to happen. Somebody's going to harass me while I'm just trying to have fun. But I have to say, I have very, very good subscribers. I just love my subscribers. I think it might be that they're maybe a little more mature. I mean, how many punk rockers play farming, really? Not to say, oh, I'm going to get in trouble here. Not to say that punk rockers are griefers. I'm not saying that. I just blurted that out for whatever reason. But anyway, there you go. Let me stop this. I got to stop talking before I get in trouble. Okay, so let's go give these guys some compost. Anyway, I was talking about... I'll try not to say anything and get me in trouble, but that you know how hard that is. I was talking about streaming, and what I'm thinking is that I was streaming on Twitch, I'm gonna try to stream on YouTube just to see what it's like. I know everybody streams on Twitch, but I've seen a few people lately that I watch occasionally that have been streaming on YouTube. So I thought, well, I'll give it a try. And since I haven't streamed in so long, I have to reset up all my software for that. I figured, why not? I'll just set it up for YouTube. And one of the things about streaming on YouTube is your stream will automatically go to YouTube when you're done. So I don't have to do anything. I don't have to record it myself. It's being recorded while I'm streaming. And now I know you can do that Twitch too, but I don't trust that. I've always, when I streamed on Twitch, I always also recorded it at the same time myself. All right, we're going to use all of our compost, and we didn't even get two of them completely full. So I'm going to get this guy out of the way. Turn him off because we're not doing anything with him at the moment. We'll wait for our water truck to get here, which should be over yonder. He might be there already. Let's see. Okay, I'll show you that. I'll show you this in a minute. I want to show you this. But let me finish. What in the hell? I didn't do the act. Oh. All right, so where am I? There's the garden shop. You got to set that, stop at the last trigger, or he doesn't know what to do when he gets here. Unfortunately, these drivers, they can't think on their own. They keep saying in Farming Simulator 2017 that the AI is going to be smarter. What does that mean? Well, I'll tell you one thing. They also said they're going to have female drivers or female farmers. Well, no wonder that the AIs are going to get smarter, because, you know, women are smarter than men on average. Okay, I got all the way over here and I don't have any water. What in the hell was I thinking? And there isn't water here. There's only seed and fertilizer, according to that. Oh, man. And the bio thing doesn't have water. Oh. Let's see. Where's our other farm is right up here. So I'll go up there and get water. But I'm going to forget what I wanted to show you. So let me just get this to the farm, and then I'll go and show you what I did. And then I think I need to get to the next day because we need to start that harvest. I need money, 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 as usual. Can I take a shortcut? All right, where's my water tank? There's the water tank. Okay. Let's fill that up and I'll show you. Let's go to, let's see, where's, there he is. Okay, so looking at the map, I'll show you where we're at. This is the big field. There's our farm right there. This is the big field 2 and the little field 1. And right next to there's the big field 4. But right in here, if you look, it doesn't look like much on the map. But in reality, this is quite a bit of grass right here. Okay, so I got my free grass up here, but I have free grass right here too. And there's little patches all over the place. There's a small little patch right here. But the two major ones are right here by the biogas and right here between field 4 and 2. So, so I set up a little route here. And I picked up the grass. Now, if we look at it, it's actually pretty good size. Let me start this guy up. Because if I take time forward, I'm going to have him start working again. But if you look, it starts off kind of narrow on this end. But look, that's quite a bit of grass. It goes around the corner and there's a great big round spot out there. So all in all, it's quite a bit of grass. And let me show you what I did. I started over in this corner up here. And I'll turn my little iSpy camera on here. And we'll select this field, which I call grass field 4, so which this needs to go up. Let me put this in grass. We'll put... Yeah, we need grass field 4 to silo. That one goes up in grass. Gracias, right there. Okay, so if we go to grass and put mole grass field 4, there's what I did right there. So it looks like a big Christmas stocking, doesn't it? Now, this doesn't show it very well because it looks like I missed a big section of grass right here. I didn't. There's trees there. They're just not showing up on this little map. Because what I did was I came up in this corner. As a matter of fact, I started a little bit too close to that tree right there. And I get hung up on it with the forage wagon. I should have started the course a little bit further in, and I didn't. So I just started right here, and I just drove around the corner. I just drove clear around the field. And said, look, this is my field. But see, there's trees out there that don't really show up on a map. I did that. And so he goes, what he does is he'll go around once, he mows around one time, and then he goes up and down until he's done. And there's actually, like I said, quite a bit of grass there. So let's turn the Christmas sock off. Christmas will get here when it's time. And yeah, I missed a little bit of grass right here picking up, but I don't care. It's just the way it is. So, let's see. What else did I do? I don't think I did anything else. Let me get this couple of vegetable things going here. And we'll... You know what? Also, I was thinking that I might... Is this one got... Okay, this one does not have... a silage pit on it, does it? This farm. I don't think it does. No, I don't see one. So this farm doesn't have a silage pit, but I was thinking of putting one of my silage fermenting silos in here, but I haven't decided where would be a good place for that. Because I don't want to block my entrances. I don't want to put it too close to where I need to move around. You know what? It might be Oh, no. I don't know. I'm thinking. I don't know where a good place would be. I could put one. Do I ever come back behind this? I don't think I do. Well, I'm just kind of thinking. Yeah, I don't want it on this end. I want it kind of out of the way, so it's not in the way anywhere. Now, here's a spot right here that's kind of not in the way, but I'd have to do it in a... Oh, no, that wouldn't work. I need a drive-through area is what I need. If I put it here, then I'm not going to have enough room to get in and out of that shed right there. I don't think. I could put it on the outside here. Let me see. Let's take a look. Placeables. Do we need the big one or the little one? I don't know. If we're going to put one in, might as well put the big one in, huh? I think they're the same size in real estate. It's just that one's taller than the other. That's my thought. So let's see about this. If we maybe turn it around this way. No, this way. Like I said, I don't know if I need to come. You know, I could do it here. Yeah, that's not good. If I put it... Now, see, the problem is I'd have to drive it in there that way. I could put it right here. Nope, I need enough room. Yeah, it would have to go... It would have to go this way. It would have to go this way, right here. Is that in the way? It does take up probably too much room to put it on the end here. Now, do I need to drive? Oh, well, I might to get to that field right there. And there's a tree in front of this one. Yeah, that's not enough room there. Not enough room there. Oh, yeah, not enough room here. Not really. So, I don't know. 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 You know, I can always move it. If I don't like where it's at, I can always move it. I could actually put it on the end here. Or maybe here. I'd have to flip it around, though. Like that. Or I could flip it. Yeah, that's not going to work. I'd have to do that right there. I just don't know. I don't know. I wish I could see where that is. Whoops, I accidentally put it there. Okay. Let's get this guy back to the garden center where he needs to be. I'm wasting time. Time is money. This might work. I don't think it's in the way. I don't need... Because I'll be coming into this way. And there's still enough room to get through there. Yeah, this will be okay. It'll be fine. Uh-oh, where am I going? Oh, I took a shortcut. There's my road. We're gonna head back this way to the garden center. Not very far, it's right there, you can see it. Okay, let's see. All right, we need to get water in those water things there. See, he neatly put where the trigger is. I like that. Good job, Stevie. You did it. Okay, so it's got compost, and it now has water. So, hey, it's already working. Look at that. Gotta love it. All right, how much water are you gonna take? My God.
I'm taking as much as I need. Leave me alone.
Okay, that's enough. This one didn't get full anyway, so he probably doesn't need that much water. So we'll just put whatever's left in this tank in there, and then we'll work on this on another day. I gotta get harvest started. Oh, I wasn't there yet. I jumped the gun a little bit. There you go. Okay, it's not doing it. Why is it not? There it goes. Yeah, see, there's not much compost in that one. There's enough to get it started. I think that's cauliflower, the first one. This is lettuce. Then we have pumpkins. And over there we have red cabbage and tomatoes. That's what my thinking is. So I'm going to stop this here and jump out of this, and I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. It's 7:50 in the morning. I slept in this morning. It's 2 days later, actually. I had to wait for the fields to ripen. And I didn't have anything else to do, so I just went ahead. Uh-oh. Danger, Will Robinson. Oh, I can get out this way. Thank you. Thank you very much. Okay, so let's get this party started. Where did I start this course? I started it. This is field 2. Harvest field 2. And I started it over yonder. No, I didn't. I started it down that way. Down in... Quit it! Oh, man. Squirrely combine. Okay, I started down in the north... the southwest corner. And the reason I did that is because it's the only square corner, really. Kind of. Well, there just isn't one on this field, really. There really isn't. A square corner, because if you look, it's got a dip down here, so this is not the farthest southern point. It is the farthest western point, but see, if I start up here, that's not the northern point. This is. So if I said start in the northwest, it would jump through up here. If I said start in the east, it would start down here, because this is the farthest eastern point. So it's kind of hard to figure out where in the hell to do this. Let me grab the header. Open up combine. Open a sesame. Now, see, this would be a good map to do live stream on, because the fields are so friggin' big that it takes you forever to harvest one field. But here's my plan, is to do this harvest. This is only my second harvest. I only harvested these fields once. This is only my second harvest. My goal is to do this harvest and... Okay, where's my starting point? That's odd. Did I miscalculate? I bet I did. I bet that's my starting point over there. Huh. Well, let's go take a look. Let's take a look. Yeah, this would be a good streaming one because it takes you forever to do a harvest. And if I stream, I could stream for a couple hours and just play. The fun thing about streaming, if there is a fun thing about streaming, I haven't made up my mind yet. Yes, there it is. And again, why is it there? Because I told it to start either in the northeast or the southeast. And what it did was, it says, well, the furthest eastern point is way out here. So that's why it started there. Silly thing. All right, well, let's do it. Anyway, as I was saying, I haven't made up my mind if there's anything that's fun about streaming yet. But if I had to guess, the fun thing about streaming would be that that you can play as long as you like. So, you know, right now when I record, because I'm recording this map for you to watch, I don't work it offline because I want you to see what I'm doing. And so that means if I play this map for however long I'm going to record, which is 30 to 40 minutes, about 40 to 40. I used to do 55 minutes a while back. I kind of stopped. I'm doing about 40 minutes now. But in 40 minutes, I get the equipment out and I'm done. Oh, I hate when it does this, and I don't know why it does it. All right, hang on. Be right back. Okay, I'm back. Anyway, I don't know what that does, but it makes it so I can't drive my rig. I can't, like right now I'm moving forward, and now I'm moving in reverse. When that happens, where it shows that arrow down there, and I'm trying to do course play, it freezes everything. I can't start course play, and then I can't even drive my rig. If I push the pedal down to go forward, it does nothing. I can't move this rig. I can go to the next rig, it works fine. But this one is frozen. And so it literally is like a game crash. And I don't know what causes it. Now you do have to remember I'm using a developer's mod of CoursePlay. Right here, you'll see I'm using the developer's version of it. So it's a beta and you know I don't know what causes that. But there you go. So let me get going with this. I was talking about live streaming and what I thought might be fun about it. And that is that I can actually just play the game. If I'm live streaming, I can just play the game. I don't have to worry about, oh, I got two more minutes and I have to end the episode. And then I won't be able to play this game until I do another episode. What are you doing? Where are you going, buddy? Let me get out here and see if I can find this course. Is that the course? That's the course. There he goes. All right, just have to find the start there. It's kind of different. But there you go. Let's get him going. Let's get the potato fella out to the field. And yeah, so anyway, streaming, I can play. Oh, shoot. I can play as long as I want. I can play 4 or 5 hours if I want to. And it streams the whole time and we'll put the video up for you to see when I'm done. There is a limit. I can't remember what it is. I think it's 6 or 8 hours. You can only stream for, I can't remember. Don't quote me on this, but it is quite a long time. It's longer than I'd want to stream. It's like 6 to 8 hours that you can actually stream and then you can't stream no more. I can stream that long and I can't go no more. Which is fine. There's no way. The only way I would stream that long is if I was doing some kind of charity where I say, hey, I'm going to stream all day for charity. You know what I mean? And then I might do an 8-hour stint. That'd be hard for me because I'm old. I need my nap in the middle of the day. But there you go. I'm having a hard time with naps lately. I never napped because I always, almost every morning I woke up nauseous. If I have to wake up and just get up, why does this thing drive so damn slow? Anyway, every day of my ute, if I had to set an alarm at 6 o'clock and I had to jump right up and get going because I had to be to work by 7. If I set my alarm for 5 o'clock because I had to be at 7, then I could lay there for a half hour comfortably and wake my lazy butt up and then get up and shower and do what I need to do to get ready for the workday. Well, I didn't like doing that. I set my alarm only giving myself enough time to get up, shower, get dressed, and hit the road. And in case there was traffic or bad weather or whatever. So consequently, I would set the alarm at 6 o'clock and jump up, and I would be nauseous every morning, because I have to be awake for at least a half hour before I'm not nauseous. And like I said, on weekends when I didn't have to jump up, I would still wake up at 6 o'clock. I hardly ever set an alarm, hardly ever. But, you know, I just 6 o'clock, I'm up. But on weekends, I would wake up and I'd lay there for a few minutes, 15, 20 minutes. And then when I got up, I wasn't nauseous. Well, it worked the same way with napping. If I would try to take a nap in the middle of the day, like maybe 1 o'clock in the afternoon, and it wouldn't matter whether I slept for an hour or 5 minutes, when I woke up, I would be nauseous. And so I never napped. Well, there came a point where one day I accidentally fell asleep. When I woke up, I wasn't nauseous. And, you know, I was, you know, a lot older now when that happened. And so I started maybe taking a little half hour, 45 minute nap. See, I worked in a different state. So I had to wake up in Oregon, go to work in Washington. And so I had a little bit of a commute, right? So, consequently, what am I doing? I don't have anything set up for this, do I? No, I do not. All right, we're going to do field work. And let's see, I can't do the same one I have because I don't think the working width of this header is the same. So anyway, for my lunch hour, I wasn't anywhere close to being able to drive home for lunch or to visit anybody that, you know, family at home or anything like that. So I decided I'd grab a sandwich or a can of soup, whatever it was I was going to eat. And I would just, let me put this thing out. I would just take a quick little 45 minute nap. So I'd have a little bit of lunch, 15 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, and then I'd lay down, take a little bit of nap. In my car, no place for me to go, too far away from home. And I ended up being able to take a nap that way. Let's see, let's start this up in this corner over yonder. And that was kind of okay, you know. Well, I don't work anymore, so I can take a nap anytime I want. But I'm finding lately that if I do, then I have trouble sleeping at night. Ow. And so I'm mixed about taking a nap anymore because I want to be able to sleep at night. I hate laying up late at night and it's dark and it's quiet and I can't sleep. And then my mind just races about all the things I may be stressing about. And that makes it worse. Now I really can't sleep. And then I'll watch TV, and I tend to watch the wrong thing. I'll watch some horror movie or something at 1 o'clock in the morning because I can't sleep. I go to bed at 10 o'clock, and I'm still awake at 1 o'clock, and I'm watching some horror movie, and then I have nightmares. And, yeah, it sucks to be me. Not really. Hey, I got to go. I'll hope you had fun. Like it if you did. Share it if you have a friend. Subscribe if you haven't. I'll see you on the farm in the next episode. Happy farming. In the meantime, I'll set this course up. See you then.